This is the regular meeting of the City Council of the City of Cottonwood to be held March 21st, 2017, 6 p.m. And Deputy Clerk, please take the roll.
Councilmember Althaus.
Here.
Councilmember Norman.
Here.
Councilmember Pfeiffer.
Here.
Councilmember Allen.
Here.
Councilmember Henry.
Here.
Vice Mayor Howergy.
Here.
Mayor Linsky.
Here. Thank you. Please stand and join me in the pledge. Thank you. All right, next item is a brief summary of current events by mayor, city council, and/or city manager. The public body does not propose, discuss, deliberate, or take legal action on any matter brought up during the summary unless a specific matter is properly noticed for legal action. Does council have anything to report?
I have one thing. I attended the Welcome Home Vietnam Vets Committee today. Councilmember Allen and Terry Payne for the MMA were unable to attend, so I attended the meeting. I just want to remind everybody that that event is Saturday, April 1st. We don't have another meeting before that. There's going to be a ride before the event that starts at the Sedona Posse Grounds with kickstands up at 11:10, arriving at the Kids Park in Cottonwood at 12:30. The event at the Kids Park does start at 12 with the Mods playing. I encourage everybody to come out and celebrate our Vietnam vets and all of our veterans to be there. I know Mayor Alinsky will be speaking at 1 o'clock along with a few other mayors from the community, but I really encourage everybody to come out and support the event. Cottonwood is sponsoring it this year. That's all I have.
Thank you. Any other council members? No? Okay. Just briefly, this Thursday morning at 10 a.m., I'll be reading to the kiddos at the Cottonwood Public Library. And Saturday, I'll be marching in the Mayor's March for meals. So everybody's welcome to join us. I believe we leave at 9 a.m. from the Senior Center. So please join us for that march. And City Manager, have you got anything to report?
Just two quick items. We are burning at the transfer station this week, and we're using the air curtain again, but I understand that we may be getting some complaints, so we'll be looking into that. If we get complaints, I don't know what we're going to do from there, but we'll see what we can work out. And the library on Saturday, April 1st, same day as the Welcome Home Vietnam Vets, the library is hosting a comic expo. And the benefits from the expo go to the summer reading programs, and it's $5 for admissions and $3 with two cans of goods. And I assume that's at the recreation center? At the recreation center. So comic expo, and we did this last year, and it was very successful, wasn't it? Okay,
great.
That's it.
Very good. Thank you. All right, next item is call to the public. If there's any members of the public out there that would like to speak during call to the public, you can fill out a yellow form, which should be found right there on the back table. We have two members of the community right now that would like to speak during call to the public. You'll be limited to 5 minutes. First is, I'm gonna ruin your name, and I'm really sorry, Anik Deschules? So sorry, would you please step forward? And please let me know how to pronounce your name. I'm sorry?
Dimon. We've met before.
Yeah.
Early Valley Homeless Coalition.
That's correct.
My name is Anik Dimon, and I'm a case manager with NACOC Community Services. Good evening, Mr. Mayor and City Council members, and thank you for allowing me to speak this evening. I just wanted to take a moment to remind you or perhaps make you aware of the services that I do offer here in the city of Cottonwood, but also in the greater Verde Valley. I help people with utility payments, low-income individuals and families, anything from electric to water to propane, gas, even wood in the winter or wood pellets. I also help with utility deposits. Just to give you an example, somebody moving into a home between electric, gas, and water can cost them close to $600 worth of utility deposits, and that's where I come in if they can't afford them. I also help with rent, with appliance repair and replacement, anything from a washer dryer to an evaporative cooler. And for those who have either lost their jobs, are looking for employment, and need help with gas, I can help with that as well. So I just wanted to take a moment and introduce myself to those who don't know me, or reintroduce or say hello to those who do know me. And I want to thank you for your time.
Thank you. And how would folks get a hold of you?
I work out of the Arizona Department of Economic Security building on Cherry Street. So if you go in the lobby, my phone number is on the directory.
Okay.
Okay. Thank you.
Thanks, Mr. Moore.
Thank you. Mr. Mayor, could you share her contact information with the council?
Certainly. So she's from NACOG Community Services, and the email, I'll share your email address if that's all right. It's C as in Charlie, S as in...
Could you do it through email with us?
Or I'm so sorry. I thought you meant with the public.
No,
with
council.
With council, certainly.
Could you share it after, or have the deputy clerk share it with us?
Sure, we can do that.
I think it's a good resource for council to have on hand.
Okay. Since I'm on a roll, I'll go ahead and share it with the public.
sorry.
No, that's all right. The email address is csacw@nacog.org. Okay. Thank you. All right. Next, we have Mr. Piper.
Mayor Tim, council members, haven't been here in a while, but I'd like to ask to just welcome home Vietnam vets with my old boys in World War II. I don't hear anything mentioned about us. Anyway, what I have to say won't take but a minute. I might step on some toes, but so be it. I witnessed yesterday and two times before that in the grocery store, Safeway's grocery store, and I'll mention it, I don't care whose toes I'm stepping on. A service dog is a service dog. That dog is meant to help the people that own the dog, not some mutt that you lead around in the store wetting on the counters. This happened yesterday. This happened twice before to my witness. I don't know if there's anything to be done about it, except there should be some kind of a law, because I do not appreciate, well, going around behind the dog, it's wetting on stuff to have to pick up the food for it. And my other one, not you've heard that one, my other one is law. Dune buggies. Trucks. If I pull out on the road with my flatbed truck or one of my trailers without my mud flaps dragging the ground, I am subject to a ticket. I pulled in behind a dune buggy here when after one of our frequent little storms. I got a cracked windshield out of it. There's no mud flaps on it. They say, well, they're built that way. They don't have to have. Well, isn't there some kind of discrimination between that and us motorists that do have to abide by the law? Isn't there a law against it? And something else I've witnessed here, I bought me one the other day. I bought me an ATV, and after I got it, I got to reading up on the laws on it. It's against the law for two people to ride front and back on an ATV. You see it all the time up and down the road. Nobody's doing nothing about it. But it's still against the law to do it. And furthermore, my ATV will have mud flaps and lights on before it gets out on the road. But why do we have to be so particular about putting money into our equipment to make it legal, make it highway legal, when you got these kind of people out there running around that don't give a damn about nobody or nothing? Do I make myself clear? One more thing I'd like to say, it may not be of any interest to anyone, but I had to put my girlfriend in a nursing home. Mm-hmm. It could turn for the worst. Thank you.
Thank you for your time, Mr. Piper. Okay, next item is item six, approval of the minutes from the strategic retreat of January 21, 2017, special meeting of February 28, 2017, special work session of February 28, 2017, and the special meeting of March 14, 2017.
I'll move to approve all minutes, or do I need to read them off? I move to approve the minutes from the strategic repeat of January 21st, special meeting of January 28th, and the work session of February 28th, and the special meeting of March 4th.
Okay. Second.
All right. So Councilmember Althaus motioned and Councilmember Allen seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? All right. The minutes are approved. Moving on to unfinished business, we have extension of contract with Patriot Disposal for solid waste removal services for the city of Cottonwood. Mr. Cook.
Mr. Mayor, Council, Jeff Cook, Purchasing and Contract Administrator. As we know, at the last meeting, this agreement extension was tabled because there was some confusion as to whether or not recycling services were part of this agreement. I did look into that, and recycling services are part of this agreement. As to the question for the fire at the facility, we have Representative Jay Ibby from Patriot Disposal who can answer any of those questions on how that has affected those, but at this time, that's what I have.
Okay. Council, would you like me to call forward?
Please.
Okay. What was the gentleman's name again?
Jay Ibby.
Jay Ibby, great. Mr. Ibby, if you wouldn't mind. Thank you.
Good?
Well, thank you.
Good. Open for questions.
So I understand there were some current concerns that you had a fire out there and recycling services may be limited at this point. Can you just elaborate a little bit on that?
Absolutely. Yes, we did have a fire late November and did destroy the facility. For the months of the last few days of November and the month of December, we were unable to do any kind of recycling there due to safety restrictions. And there was both a fire investigation and an arson investigation to follow that. Mm-hmm. As we were cleared from that, as soon as they told us it was safe to do so, we did start now back with our manual, very manual process. Some of you came and saw the process that we did have. Basically now, it's on the concrete floor, and instead of coming across the sort line, my guys are pulling the recyclables out of a pile. Is it efficient? Not at all. It is what we can do. For the next about 75 days, we hope to be back in full operation.
After 75 days?
Yeah. Okay. That's my guess. We're 75 to 90, depending on some. We do have some permitting items that I don't have control over, but otherwise, yeah, we should be back in.
Okay.
Great.
And hopefully with a improved, and then I'd like to put another invitation out to you once it's done. Okay. We're looking at some new mechanical improvements. When you saw it, it was very, all was completely physically done by hand, but now we're adding a few automation items that hopefully will bring our percentage of recycling up from that.
Great, okay.
I would ask, just as an aside, when you get that up and running, if you would send us a little invitation, and we would love to come out and see your new facility.
Yeah, I would love to have you there.
Okay.
And at the same time, I'd like for some time for you guys to come see, or I can bring them here. Mm-hmm. We're running in our green initiative, we have 9 new compressed natural gas trucks that you should see running through town.
Mm-hmm.
They're blue. You'll see them different than the red, white, and blue ones. They're solid blue. But those are running off of complete clean energy, no emissions. And if you notice, they're much quieter. So they can't sneak up on us.
Okay.
Very good.
I just have a quick
please,
question.
Councilor
are you
Henry.
Able to put a number or, I guess, a percentage difference on the amount of recyclables captured
yes.
manually versus using the automated system?
Sir, if you would, just pull the microphone a little bit closer to you, please. Thank you.
Better. Very small. I mean, we were doing over 120 tons a week prior when we were fully running, and we're probably doing, we're not even keep track, it's 20 or 30 tons now, so probably a quarter of what we were doing beforehand. And each week that's getting a little bit better, but again, it's not going to be anything compared to what we were doing before.
Thank you.
Yes.
Okay. Any further discussion from council?
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Does that answer the council's questions?
Absolutely.
Yes.
Okay, great. Then I go ahead and move to renew the contract for solid waste removal services for 1 additional year to Patriot Disposal.
Second.
Okay. Mayor made the motion. Vice Mayor seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
All right. Any opposed? The motion's approved. Thank you. All right. Moving on to the consent agenda, we have 4 items. Item 1, resolution number 268, 2865, authorizing the police department to submit a fiscal year 2018 grant proposal to the governor's office of highway safety, seeking funds to cover overtime expenses associated with the department's DUI task force. Item 2, resolution number 2864, authorizing the submission of a grant proposal in connection with the governor's office of highway safety fiscal year 2018 funding cycle for selective traffic enforcement patrol overtime costs. Item 3, new liquor license application submitted by Michelle R. Malkin, applicant for Girona Cafe, located at 677 East Mingus Avenue. And item 4 is resolution number 2874, affirming the city's fair housing policy, making known the city's commitment to the principle of fair housing, and describing actions to the city shall undertake to affirmatively further fair housing. Any members of the council that would like any of these items pooled for discussion? No? Any members of the public which would like any item pooled for discussion? Okay. Do I hear a motion?
I move we approve the consent agenda. Okay.
Second.
Okay. Councilmember Norman moved to approve, and Councilmember Allen seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed?
Aye. Sorry, I was late.
Okay. So the consent agenda is approved. Thank you. All right, moving on to new business. Item 1.
Mr. Mayor.
Yes. Oh, I'm so sorry. The resolutions to read. Excuse me. Please, Deputy Clerk, read resolution number 2865.
Resolution number 2865, a resolution of the Mayor and City Council of the City of Cottonwood, Yavapai County, Arizona, authorizing the Police Department to submit a fiscal year 2018 grant proposal to the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, seeking funds to cover overtime expenses associated with the department's DUI task force detail. Resolution number 2864, a resolution of the Mayor and City Council of the City of Cottonwood, Yavapai County, Arizona, authorizing the submission of a grant proposal in connection with the Governor's Office of Highway Safety fiscal year 2018 funding cycle for selective traffic enforcement patrol overtime costs. And resolution number 2874, a resolution of the Mayor and City Council of the City of Cottonwood, Yavapai County, Arizona, affirming a fair housing policy, making known its commitment to the principle of fair housing, and describing actions it shall undertake to affirmatively further fair housing. Mr. Mayor.
All right, thank you. Okay, new business. Item 1 is reappointing Kent Hellman to the city's public safety personnel retirement board. So the next 4 items under new business have to do with appointing members to our commissions, and we council did approve a new process for doing this, and I think that there was, because it's a new process, just a little bit of confusion about how to follow through with this, and it's been brought to my attention that there were perhaps several applicants for the Safety Personnel Retirement Board, so I'd like to get a little bit more clarification on that, because it looks like we're only considering one applicant at this time.
Mayor, Council, when I gathered there was only one applicant, which was Kent Hellman.
Okay.
For this particular position.
Okay. Because we had appointed Councilmember Norman to serve on the selection committee, mm-hmm. and if you wouldn't mind.
Iris, what 2 did I turn into you? P&Z?
P&Z and Personnel Board, probably.
Oh, Personnel Board. Yeah. That's right. I'm sorry. Okay.
That's okay. So then there was only one applicant for the Personnel Board. Okay, very good. And so you reviewed just the one for the Personnel Board. Is that correct?
I didn't do any for the Personnel Board.
You wouldn't
retirement
do it if there
board.
Was only one?
There was only one, so.
Oh, I see. So the ones that you reviewed
was Personnel and P&Z.
Planning and zoning.
Not safety personnel, but regular personnel.
Oh, I see. And we're not considering that tonight.
Just the Public Safety Personnel Board.
Okay. Okay. Then that makes a lot more sense.
That makes more sense.
Okay.
That's where I was.
Thanks for the clarification. So then we can go ahead and move forward with this item. Item 1, reappointing Kent Hellman to the city's Public Safety Personnel Retirement Board. So, for the public's benefit, we put together a selection committee that scored the applicants on a blind matrix based off their qualifications for the duty of whatever committee they're, commission they're applying for. In this case, there was only one opening, one applicant. So it's really a simple process to just appoint the person who applied. In the case of Planning and Zoning Commission, of course, there are more applicants than seats available. So in that case, which will come up shortly here, we'll interview the applicants, and the council then will score those folks based off of another metrics. We'll combine those two totals and make a recommendation on who should fill those seats. But in this case, we only have the one applicant for the one vacant seat. So, Mr. Rodriguez.
My apologies. My name is Rudy Rodriguez. I'm the Admin Services General Manager for the City of Cottonwood. I'm still trying to get used to the process. You have the application is attached, and I'll try to answer as many questions as I can. And that's really all I have, seeing that we only have one applicant.
Very good. And is Mr. Hellman here this evening?
I am. I'm almost certain he's not here. I was told that he wouldn't be able to attend the meeting.
Okay. Very good. Are there any questions from council on this? I discovered upon becoming mayor that I too serve on this and have served with Kent, and the meetings are very short, but he's always there. So I can offer that at least to council.
Can I make a motion?
The only thing I would add is, and I said this at the last meeting, is I think when we're appointing people, it would be nice to put a face, you know, and mm-hmm. I understand people have other commitments and other stuff going on, but it would be nice if it's sometime he could come and just introduce himself.
Certainly, we'll go ahead and mention it to him if he'd at least like to get him, not like to, but try to get him in here to introduce himself, mm-hmm. at least. I think that's a good point.
Yeah, I agree.
Very good. Okay. Make a motion.
Please.
I move to reappoint Kent Hellman to the Public Safety Personnel Retirement Board for a 4-year term, which expires December 31st, 2020.
Second.
Okay, Councilmember Allen made a motion, and Councilmember Henry seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? So the motion is approved. Very good. Okay, we move on then to...
Thank you, Mayor Council.
Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Item 2, resolution number 2866, appointing a member to the Library Advisory Board to fill the remainder of a 3-year term. I appreciate the public's patience as we work through this. I'd like to call forward Vanessa Ward, Library Manager. Thank you. Please introduce yourself to the public.
Vanessa Ward, I'm the Public Library Manager. Good evening, Mayor, members. I have allergies going on, so excuse my voice. I am here asking you to approve resolution number 2866 to appoint Jackie Marin to our Library Advisory Board. She was our one applicant, and I do have her here if you have any questions or anything you'd like to ask.
Very good, thank you. And there was only one opening on your
yes.
on your board? Okay,
yes.
Very good.
She is actually finishing out a term from when that moved, and the term ends January of 2018.
Okay, very good. Then if Jacqueline Nairn is here tonight, if we could call her forward.
Yes.
Welcome. Thank you for being here.
Thank you.
If you would just introduce yourself to the council.
I'm Jackie Nairn.
Very good. Would you like to just, I guess we can ask any questions we want, but I'm curious to know why you'd like to serve on the library Advisory Board.
Well, as many of you know, I've been looking for a way to give back to the community for some time now, and looking at the options for volunteering with the city, it makes the most sense to me to be on the library board. I'm an avid reader. I use the library almost daily in and out of there, and I'm also writing my first book. So in that sense, books are very important to me. So it makes a lot of sense for me to volunteer at the library.
Very good. Any other questions, Council?
I don't have a question, but Jackie, you know, ran for city council, and I was very impressed, you know, by Jackie, and we sort of became friends through the process, and I think you'll do a wonderful job on the library board. I think she'll be great.
Very good.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Well, I do appreciate you filling out an application very much.
I'll go ahead and make a motion if you'd like. I move to approve resolution number 2866, supporting Jackie Naren as a member of the Library Advisory Board to fill the remainder of a three-year term, which expires January 21st, 2018. Sorry, took us back in time there for a second.
Second.
Okay, so Councilmember Althaus made the motion. Councilmember Pfeiffer seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Okay, any opposed? All right, motion passes. Thank you, Ms. Naren, very much.
Thank you,
appreciate
Jackie.
Okay, Deputy Clerk, please read resolution number 2866.
Resolution number 2866, a resolution of the Mayor and City Council of the City of Cottonwood, Arizona, appointing Jackie Naren, a member of the Library Advisory Board of the City of Cottonwood, and establishing her term of office. Mr. Mayor.
Very good. Okay, item three, interview of applicants for the Planning and Zoning Commission. I have another question quickly before you step down. In our packet were included the blind matrices. The concern I have is that there are only three, but it's a four-member selection committee. So I'd like to, if it's all right with council, go ahead and move forward with the interviews today, but I'd like to make sure that that fourth member of the selection committee is able to review the applicants and still score at the applicants. And I realize that if you would, Ms. Dobler, please step forward.
Iris Dobler, short-term human resources manager for the city. The reason there was not a fourth person is because the chairperson was also an applicant.
Okay.
And it was my understanding that they were not supposed to do a matrix if they were an applicant, and that's why you only had three.
Okay. But would the vice chair then step in to fill that seat, since the vice chair is typically the one that
could,
fills in?
Okay. If that's how you want to handle it, yes.
Okay.
Or someone else, but I didn't know who else to select.
So. Okay. How does that sound to council? Should we have just to round out the four-member committee, should we go ahead and have the vice chair fill in for the chair in this situation? And situations moving forward, I think that seems like that would make the most sense. Okay. All right. Then, Ms. Najat, are you here this evening? Yes, I'm looking right at you. Would you like me to Ms. Najat? Would you like me to run through this?
Please.
Okay. Okay. So you're okay with just staying?
Sure,
okay.
Yeah. We have four applicants and we have three openings.
Okay. Very good.
Don't we have six applicants? What are we doing here? Planning and zoning. We have six applicants.
That's what I have.
I have six.
Oh, no. There's
three open seats and there's...
Six applicants.
There's six applications.
Yes, there's six. Okay. Six have been evaluated.
Yeah, the evaluations included six.
Yeah,
so
that's right.
We have six applicants.
That's correct.
Should she correct?
Well, hopefully all six are here tonight for the interview, so we'll move forward with the interview.
So we have three openings, just to correct it, we have three openings and six applicants.
That's correct. That's correct. Councilmember Norman.
And since I was the council evaluator, I'm going to step down.
Very good. And again, for the public's benefit, and we do appreciate your patience as we work through this process, Councilmember Norman is on that selection committee. What council decided was that whoever serves from the council on that selection committee would then recuse himself during the public interview process, which is what we're going to start right now. So. Okay. Council, you each have your matrix in front of you. So we're going to ask these questions to each applicant. I'm going to go down the list here as they are presented in our packet. We have a Joseph Smith. Are you in the room tonight? Mr. Smith, would you please step forward? Thank you for applying for the Planning and Zoning Commission. So we have some questions that we're going to ask you. Okay, and I'll go down the list. We're going to ask each applicant the same question. The first question is, please tell us why you wish to serve on this board or commission. Second question is, what are your specific qualifications for this board commission? Third question is, what do you hope to accomplish during your appointment? And those are the three questions that we'll ask you, and then we'll give you an opportunity to ask any questions of us. Does that sound fair? Very good. Thanks again for being here. Okay, so Mr. Smith, please tell us why you wish to serve on this board of commission.
First, my name is pronounced Smythe.
Smythe, I apologize.
That's okay. Just know that.
Okay.
So the first question again, please.
Please tell us why you wish to serve on this board or commission.
I've lived in the Valley for about 25 years, and most of that time my work has carried me away from the Valley. But I've learned to love the Valley, and I've loved to learn this city. Mm-hmm. And I'm very interested in the city and would like to take part now that I'm clear that I'm going to be here.
Very good.
And I have a background in the various subjects that we're talking about. My background is architecture, planning, and development. I've served on boards before, and I've been in front of city councils and behind the desk as well.
Okay.
I came from California, where I had a planning practice for 10 years. And so, with that said, my main interest is to do what I can to encourage the citizenry to look into how to move the community toward a sustainable future. Mm-hmm. We're dealing with really big challenges across the whole country and around the world, and it really needs to start at the local level. Mm-hmm. So I'm really interested in those subjects. Mm-hmm. And there's lots of great ways to easily, without a lot of disruption, start looking into sustainability. So I have that as a central theme.
Okay, very good. Second question is, what are your specific qualifications for this commission?
Well, I just touched on a few, mm-hmm. so I'm happy to answer any questions about those.
If you wanted to just flesh out any of the details, we have your resume in front of us, but the members of the public do not. So if you wanted to...
Right. So, like I said, I had a planning practice in Thousand Oaks, California for 10 years, and I've got master's degrees in system design, architecture, and planning and development.
Okay.
My first work was on the East Coast, where I was the chief designer of the Children's Hospital National Medical Center, mm-hmm. in Washington, D.C. when I was 29 years old.
Okay.
It was a $70 million hospital at the time. It took 3 years to design, so I had a lot of experience working with the city of Washington and lots of different interest groups. I then did a planned community development in Pennsylvania, where I was the chief developer and planner and designer, and that was a wonderful experience to have. And then I've done a lot of development work where I've built subdivisions, and mm-hmm. I know what's involved in those things. And
okay.
So again, the progression of my career has always been around protection of a balanced version of economics, which has to do with triple bottom line economics, mm-hmm. as opposed to just money. So it's economics, money, which absolutely has to be profitable. It's social, and it's environmental. And that triple bottom line economics model is what I believe all businesses and governments ought to be using for making their decisions.
Very good, thank you. Last question. What do you hope to accomplish during your appointment?
To get people to get engaged in the city. And, you know, as large as this city is, this is a pretty small place for the public to come. Mm-hmm. And I'd like to see that need to change, where there's lots of people coming and taking part and participating.
Very good. Very good. Do you have any questions for us? Then now's your chance to put us on the spot.
Well, I guess I would ask, have you all thought about sustainability, about how you move the town toward that model? I mean, we're all facing environmental, social, and economic issues related to these subjects, and I'm just wondering if you've ever discussed it or if you're interested in creating a long-term plan that speaks to this. Most cities don't even have a plan for moving in that direction, which is the only way we have to go.
Mm-hmm.
Have you all ever talked about it or thought about it?
There are elements of that in our general plan, in fact.
Excuse me?
There are elements of that in our general plan. So, yeah, the Planning and Zoning Commission has looked into that. Yeah. It's important to me. I can't speak for the entire council, but I imagine most of us would agree it's important.
I'd like to hear from other people about that on the council.
Sure.
I'd have to agree with, I mean, if you review our general plan and our utilities plans and other things that we've gone through, you'll see that we're definitely moving towards sustainability throughout the city. It's not going to be in huge steps. We can't do it in huge steps, but a step at a time.
Yeah. All right. Mr. Smith, I appreciate you filling out an application. Thanks for being here tonight.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Tim, I have a quick question.
Sure.
We have three areas, but four scorings on the overall. Are we doing all four?
Mm-hmm, please.
Thank you.
Yep. Okay, next is Jill Clark. Are you in tonight? Thank you for being here tonight.
Thank you for having me.
And I noticed, too, that you have double dipped, right? You filled out one for the Historic Preservation Commission as well. Isn't that correct?
I want to be involved.
Okay. All right. Well, thanks again for being here. So we're going to ask you the same three questions. And first up is, please tell us why you wish to serve on this board or commission.
Okay.
Jill, hold that towards you a little bit, the mic. There you go.
Is that better?
Yes.
All right. So my name is Jill Clark, and I am a relatively new member of the community. I've been here for a couple of years. However, I've been in Arizona most of my life. I grew up in Flagstaff. I'm an NAU graduate. In the interest of my career, my husband and I moved to Phoenix, where we resided for the last 16 years. And I think the biggest thing I learned in Phoenix is it is very hard to be involved in a community of that size. And we had chosen Cottonwood in the Verde Valley as the place we would retire eventually. And we were really happy when a turn of events brought us here. And I was able to find a really great job. And we've built a new home and are very happily residing in Cottonwood. I have a strong desire to serve. I was very involved in the Flagstaff community. Graduate of the Flagstaff Leadership Program. I'm currently involved in the Verde Valley Leadership Program. Will graduate in July, and then have been asked to join that board of directors. I love Cottonwood. I've been very impressed with the growth I've seen, especially in the Old Town area from years ago when I used to come here as a tourist to where we are now. And I would like to be a part of that growth in a positive way. I'm an Arizona girl, and I plan to be here for the rest of my life.
Very good. Thank you. Question two, what are your specific qualifications for this commission?
So I will admit I don't have specific qualifications other than my love and compassion for this community and my desire to see it grow in a positive and sustainable way and to provide jobs and housing and a good place for people to raise their families.
Okay. What do you hope to accomplish during your appointment?
I hope to learn as much as I can about the city, about the council, and find other ways to become involved and grow politically in the community and have Mayor Alinsky's job one day. There.
Good.
There's.
I love it. That's great. All right. Last is, do you have any questions for us?
You know, I guess the only question I can really think of is when you're thinking about the Planning and Zoning Commission, what do you think is the biggest impact that that commission can have, and how can I be the most valuable?
I started out on the Planning and Zoning Commission. I think it's an extremely valuable commission here in Cottonwood. Maybe my opinion alone, but many things that come before the commission, the council never sees. So, you know, you have the ability really to change the quality of design and development here in Cottonwood. So this commission is probably far and away one of the most important commissions we have in Cottonwood.
Great.
Yeah. And I second that comment by Mayor Linsky, because really this commission plays a vital part in the face of Cottonwood. You mentioned during your presentation that you have been impressed with the growth that you've seen in these past few years. Well, I can tell you that planning and zoning has played an integral part in the growth. We're right now actively working on, as council, recommendations from PNC on the new buildings that are going on and on, you know, amendments, revisions to existing structures. So I think that you are very vital and active. And something that I look for, you know, to answer that part of your question, is somebody that really does care about the city, that, you know, in, has their eyes open, that looks at, you know, what do we look like? How will this change actually affect us, and has a vision for the city? So.
Wonderful.
Very good. Thank you for being here tonight. Appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Jill.
Okay, next up we have Patrick Scanlon. Are you in this evening? Please step forward, Patrick. And introduce yourself, Mr. Scanlon, if you could. Make sure that mic is directed at your...
Hi, I'm Patrick Scanlon.
Thank you.
Can you hear that?
Yes, we can. Thank you. Thanks for being here.
I live at 305 South 18th Street here in Cottonwood.
Thanks for being here tonight. Thanks for filling out an application.
Sure.
So, again, the same three questions. Please tell us why you wish to serve on this commission.
Well, I think that Planning and Zoning Commission has an invisible sort of not noticed much until it's too late effect on the community. And that it's that point in the process where somebody comes and wants to build or develop that close listening is called for, so that you can think about the effects long-term for the people who live here now, for people that live here who will be having kids, hopefully, that will live here, and the effect that that will have on everything from sewage disposal to water supply to traffic patterns to, I think I couldn't hear well, but I think the second fellow there was talking about sustainability. And what sounds good in the short term, like, oh boy, somebody's gonna come and invest money or build a building or make a motel or anything like that. What's that gonna be like in 5 years? And what's that gonna mean? How much is it gonna cost the town to provide services? Mm-hmm. And I also think that if I have an agenda, the agenda is that Cottonwood does best when Cottonwood, and I think Karen would agree and Reuben would agree with this, because they were here, was it 17, 20 years ago, when I was saying the same thing, is that leadership by example works, and leadership by decree is just leadership by decree. It's a bunch of hot air. It has to be backed up. Sure, it can be enforced by rule of law, but when things are intrinsic and they generate from the example that the leaders give and the doers give, you don't have to enforce it. People want to join in. And then people from other areas say, hey, what's going on over there that's so groovy? And they come, and by God, they're here now. I think the federal government pitched in on a grant for the streetlights, and but the rest of it has been people thinking it up as we go. And it didn't take a lot of money to get it going in the beginning. It took a grant to get those streetlights and things, but I think Old Town is doing pretty good by itself now, and I think there's a lot more to Cottonwood than just Old Town. And I you know, I'm an advocate of Old Town. I've been here a long time, and so there. That's what I got to say.
Okay. We'll move on to the second question. What are your specific qualifications for this commission?
Well, I know what I'm doing when it comes to resurrecting old buildings. I think long term, down the road, the things that I was doing 20 years ago, and there's two people here tonight. Well, Linda, too, was, weren't you around back then? Yeah. I said, this is what's going to happen. It's inevitable that it's going to happen. Let's make it go faster by generating the synergy, if you will. There's a 50-cent word for you. Let's generate some of this ourselves. You know, we got people to volunteer for what you got to pay a lot of money out now. You know, you're paying some fair-sized salaries for what people were doing for free before. And so I'm glad it's evolved and that we've got official positions for what we had volunteers to do before. But I really do ascribe to that it's from within that's going to make the difference.
Mm-hmm.
And I also think that planning and zoning can do a lot to gin up interest where it's needed. I've done it myself, and I know other people. When we've got somebody who gets paid a pretty good salary to interest viable businesses and coming to Cottonwood and setting up that are already set up other places or wanting to start out, and I'm a firm believer in that. I think we have the resources right here. We don't have to look outside so much.
All right, next question is, what do you hope to accomplish during your appointment?
Just common sense and experience. I think that I've proven for a long time I have the best interest of the community at heart. And my favorite word isn't no, and my favorite word isn't yes. I come from a family where we'll see means no. And when I say we'll see, I'm going to think about it. You know, so I like to see growth. I like to see sustainable, reasonable growth. And when people have big ideas, sometimes the big ideas come in and invest some money or buy a piece of land and sit on it and wait for everybody else to work and make that land worth more money, and then they can sell it and make a lot of money, like this thing across the street. And I'm quite sure that wouldn't happen if I was on the Planning and Zoning Board. I want to raise hell, and there it sits, and it'll get sold to somebody.
Okay.
That kind of mistake, I think, I could
okay.
Or at least participate in a positive solution to it.
Okay. Now, do you have any questions for us?
No, not really. Do I get the job?
That's a great question. We can't answer that tonight.
This has become quite the process, Tim.
It is, I know. It
Jesus.
Is.
Okay.
Thanks for being here.
Bye, everyone.
Thank you.
All right. Moving on here, we have Judd Wasden. Are you in the room tonight?
I am barely.
Thank you for being here, Mr. Wasden. Thanks for filling out an application.
No problem. I too, somebody mentioned the allergies, so I'm being kept up by some over-the-counter medications, so yep. lots of pollen out there.
Should have some interesting answers then, huh?
Yeah. Hope it doesn't affect your interview.
Just on the record.
Okay. Yeah, I think many of us are suffering from the allergies today. All right, same questions. Number one, please tell us why you wish to serve on this commission.
I have had the pleasure to serve on the commission for a few years. My interest really was as new residents. We've been in the area 12 years now. We had a development come in next to us, and some developers who presented to us a project that was presented differently to the city. And it was really, back then there was two commissions. There was a design and review and a planning and zoning. And it was, as a citizen with some of those concerns, it was a difficult process to navigate. And that really kind of piqued my interest in doing something about that process and stepping in and being able to, in my opinion, make that a better process for the community and as a citizen.
Mm-hmm.
So I originally started off and served on the Design and Review Board for a couple years. That was later on incorporated into Planning and Zoning,
mm-hmm.
And I've served there, like I mentioned, for a few years now.
Okay, very good. What are your specific qualifications for this commission?
Sometimes I ask myself those questions. I think everybody here has an interest in volunteering. Certainly the community that we live in is at the heart of my interest. Living here, you want to be in a community that is growing, is providing opportunities, and is making good decisions. I've got a varied background. I spent a number of years doing consulting in business, project management for a construction material company. I started a business here in Old Town and operate a business with my wife. And so I've got a variety of experience over the years.
Okay. What do you hope to accomplish during your appointment?
I think for me, continued improvement. I think as sitting on the Planning and Zoning Commission, We get a lot of applicants that come in that want, that are current business owners that want to make improvements or do some upgrades. And that's an opportunity for us as a community, and in particular as the Planning and Zoning Commission, to ensure that we're raising the standard up. We have a wonderful community. I think over the years, several people have mentioned already that the changes, and that's by and large due to people wanting to do that and sometimes people being encouraged to do that. And that's where planning and zoning, city council, those type of positions, I think are very beneficial. So that improvement, I think, is important, and also consistency. I think over the years, it's hard to make the consistency across the board, and I'm an advocate of that, a big believer in that. Whether the city's involved in a project or it's a private member of the community, these people are investing in our community, and I think we need to be consistent with everybody and make sure that that's a fair process for all applicants.
Okay, very good. Any questions for us?
I don't have any questions. I have like a comment, so I guess I'll throw it in as a question. I'll throw a question mark at the end, but Old Town is such a great place. Several people have mentioned over the years the transition, and I think it's a real opportunity. I think the city's done a great job in expanding parking lots. I would just encourage that. I know we do that at a planning and zoning level. Encourage that. We're at a point where we're getting a lot of attention, and it's good attention. People that come here stay at a variety of locations. They don't just visit Old Town, they visit across the board. Or that we as a city invest in Old Town and improving Old Town, it's money well spent, and it's money that will come back to us, I think, many, many fold. And so I appreciate the opportunity to apply.
Thank you. Thanks for being here again. Okay. Mr. Ed Kyler. Thank you for being here tonight.
Sir?
Thank you for being here tonight.
You're welcome. It's my pleasure to be here. To Mayor, Council, and my name is Ed Kyler. I have been a resident of the city of Cottonwood for the past 17 years. Enjoyed every minute of it. And my purpose is to continue the job that I started with some 15 years ago when I was first appointed to the Planning and Zoning Commission.
Okay. You're answering question one, right? Which is, please tell us why you wish to serve on this commission.
Well, to continue to the growth that's happened here, which the commission has been able to control to a certain extent and keep us within the guidelines of our general plan. Mm-hmm. The rural, maintain the small town attitude, but know that we're going to get bigger.
Mm-hmm. Okay. The second question is, what are your specific qualifications for this commission?
I'd say 15 years right now as a member of the Cottonwood Planning and Zoning Commission. And about 10 years as chairman of the Planning and Zoning Commission. I was part of the committee, of course, from Planning and Zoning to put together the plan, the general plan for Cottonwood and its upgrades and changes over the years.
Okay. And Mr. Kyler, what do you hope to accomplish during your appointment?
To continue the attitude that the city has towards growth and seeing that we follow our general plan to as best we can and to keep the city going, growing.
Okay. Do you have any questions for us?
No, sir, I do not.
Okay. Thanks for being here tonight.
Thank you.
And last, we have Mr. Thomas Narwood. Thank you, sir, for filling out an application. Thanks for being here tonight.
I'd like to thank you, Mr. Mayor, and council members for reviewing my application.
Same three questions. You probably know them by heart, I'm sure, at this point. But the first is, please tell us why you wish to serve on this commission.
Well, my wife and I moved to the Cottonwood area, to the Verde Valley, about 19 years ago. And the valley and Cottonwood has provided us with a very comfortable living, a nice place to live, and we expect to continue to live in the valley. I served recently, the past year, on the Planning Commission as a commissioner, and I'm reapplying for that position. Mm-hmm. And I also have a real allergy problem, so I'm really sorry about my voice.
It's okay.
You know, breaking up. And so we expect to continue to live in the valley and to spend more time, you know, in the valley. And it's a great place to live, and we very much appreciate being here.
Okay. Second question, what are your specific qualifications for this commission?
I served as a commissioner at a Quantic Township in New Jersey for 7 years. And of course, I just mentioned that I'm a commissioner here in Cottonwood for the past year. Mm-hmm. I filled in a position for a previous member.
Okay. And the third question, what do you hope to accomplish during your appointment?
Well, in the 19 years that I've lived here, I've seen some tremendous growth within the community. And I look upon Cottonwood today as probably going through a major transition. It's a turning point for the community. And I see that the growth that we're going to have to manage has to be done in an orderly way, has to be filled completely with our general plan and our specific plans within the planning and zoning ordinances. And those two things have to work in conjunction with the overall goals that the council has as a council and all the rest of the members within the planning board need to continue to cooperate and to move with the community in its development. And Old Town Cottonwood has been mentioned several times, and I think that there's other areas of development within the community that we need to begin to look at and to provide the same principles of development for those areas of the town that will need to be addressed in the future, particularly with respect to economic growth and orderly growth within the residential communities and how we allocate residential versus commercial. When I look at the map of the town, it's almost a hodgepodge of different developments over a large number of years. And I think we have to be a little bit more careful in developing the future lands that we have open for development and pay very close attention to that area.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Very good. Do you have any questions for us?
I do. I have one question in general, and I was just wondering, you know, if any of the council members, including yourself, Mr. Linsky, where you feel the biggest problems will be for the town in the next 10, 15 years relative to growth and what the Planning and Zoning Commission needs to look into and look forward to. Where do you see the biggest problems for the community?
Would you care to answer that?
I would say there are challenges and opportunities. I wouldn't call them problems, but just the growth that we're going to have, as you were kind of alluding to. I think we are going to have a great deal more growth. I think we are recovering economy, and we're going to have more homes sold with our multiple developments that we've got going on. And I think being able to provide the services to those individuals, the residents, this is probably our biggest challenge. I'm not sure that that's planning and zoning's challenge, but it's definitely the city's challenge.
Yeah, because I was wondering whether or not the economic growth would, the overall impending underneath economic growth is going to
to be able to, the economics can continue with the physical growth of new people coming into the community.
And that's a good point. I think that, you know, we'd be foolish if we said we're not going to grow as a community. We're going to grow by numbers. Maybe not exponential, but we're certainly going to grow a lot. And I think, you know, what's important to me is to make sure that the growth that is coming is directed in a way that it helps us maintain our economic posture in rural Arizona. So, you know, we have to really direct that growth in a way that's going to secure our future economically here in Cottonwood, not just hodgepodge growth or, you know, first come, first serve type growth, but really a focused, directed growth.
Right. During the past year, while I was on the board, looked at all of the potential developments, okay, 89 and Vine, the vineyards coming in recently, and it was astounding when you added up the number of people that are going to be added to the community just by three or four developments that are under development now. The town is going to double in population in the next 8 to 10 years if those plans come through.
That's true.
And that's not count any new ones that are going to come in.
Right. That's true. Thank you, Mr. Narwood.
Thank you.
Appreciate your time.
Mayor, I have a question when
you're
ready. So the specifications for planning and zoning state that it's a 7 city residents appointed to the city council, at least 2 of whom shall be qualified by design-related background training or experience, including architecture, landscape, interior design, planning, fine arts, or other design-related background. The print is very small, people. So how, as a council, knowing that we have 3 open seats, do we ensure that we still have 2 people meeting these qualifications, given the what we've been given in the applicants, and I mean, not knowing the other 7 people on? I mean, how are we ensuring that we're keeping those 2? Mayor, that was my question for Ms. Najad. Perhaps she can speak to the other current members of the commission and whether or not that requirement is already met.
Yes. Currently, we have a design.
If you would, Ms. Najad, please just introduce yourself. It's okay. Thank you.
Mayor Najad, Community Development Director. We already have a design background commissioner.
And who is that?
It's Suzanne Pascalico.
Okay. So there's one current that meets the requirements,
right,
and this new round that must meet the requirement. Okay, thank you.
And if we may, and I didn't catch your last name.
Najar.
And I don't know if this is appropriate, but I believe only 1 of these 6 have that qualification. Is that... That would be, and I'm going to say it wrong.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to try, Mr. Smythe. Is that correct?
Mr. Smythe did have an extensive background.
In my opinion, has that qualification, and maybe it's not presented in the other applicants, but I just want to make sure that we're following our protocol and making sure that when we're selecting 3 members, that we're making sure 2 meet these qualifications.
Mm-hmm. I understand your point. It's a point well taken.
Maybe I'm not making it.
No, you're making it clear,
thank you.
And I understand your point. And, certainly, during the scoring process, which the selection committee did and which we're doing now here tonight, you know, we're scoring people based off of their specific qualifications to the board. So I'm hoping that those who are more qualified to serve would rise to the top. But to answer your question, how are we filling those seats?
How are we ensuring that when we select 3 out of these 6, that we, if we only have 1 person who's meeting this qualification, how are we ensuring that one of the others do? Mm-hmm. And I'm not sure. And like you said, this is a new process,
right.
So this is our first time going through it.
Sure.
But how are we as a council ensuring that we're meeting our own qualifications?
Yeah, it's a great question. I think it may be a question probably not for Ms. Najad, but Ms. Dobler, our human resources, I think, you know, we try to weed those applicants out initially that simply aren't, either they're not a city resident, if a city resident's required, or otherwise, but that's, you know, that's an open question.
I guess I would invite, if I'm incorrect and somebody else meets that qualification, I don't know if that's appropriate, but it, from what I can see, only the one of the six meet that qualification. From what I can see from the applicants, and Ms. Allen may disagree with me because she just...
No, I think the way we move forward is, you know, what we're going to do is human resources will take these two matrices and combine them. And then we'll look at who the top
three are
in this situation. And if one of those top members does not fall in line with the criteria that we've outlined as far as their qualifications, and Historic Preservation Commission is the same way. We have very specific seats that need to be filled on that commission. I would say that if one of those top three that scored the highest doesn't meet very specific qualifications, then we would have to select from the fourth.
Yeah.
Potentially the fifth, and then potentially
the sixth. I'm just trying to get clarification. Yeah,
I think that's how we would move forward with this, but new process.
Exactly. You know,
we're all kind of feeling our way through this. So, but I think unless I hear different from council, I think that'd probably be the best way to handle the situation.
Thank you.
Good question.
Thank you. So do we pass?
So here's the deal: is for those who applied, thank you very much. We're not going to make the decision tonight. So we're going to, again, combine these scores and then come up with a recommendation at a future council meeting, and we'll let you know what the results of that decision are. But to each and every one of you, thank you for filling out an application. Thanks for wanting to serve Cottonwood. Appreciate it. Mr. Piper, I didn't see your application in there, but I look forward to it next time. Okay, so then we move on to...
We turn these into the city clerk, or how do we do that?
Yeah, we'll turn them into the clerk. So moving on then is resolution numbers 2871, 2872, and 2873, appointing members to the Historic Preservation Commission. And I believe that I need to step down for this one.
Yes, sir. That would be your prerogative.
Okay, I'm going to step down and let Vice Mayor step in.
Okay, we'll have resolutions number 2871, 2872, and 2873, appointing members to the Historic Preservation Commission. And who is going to present this?
I think you are.
Anybody?
I think she just left.
Do we have anybody here? No, it's a city manager. I mean,
the applicant's here tonight.
Vera Nejad, Community Development Director again, and we have seven members of the commission. Currently, we have three openings, and we are hoping to fill some of them at least tonight.
Do we have the applicants here tonight?
Actually, one of them is Chairman Walensky, and okay. He's outside. And honestly, we don't have the applicants. I don't know who's the second one. Because
Jill is here. Was here. Jill Clark. She actually interviewed for the Planning and Zoning Commission position. She was here. But I don't know about Felicia Coates.
Doesn't look like it.
Is she back?
So, Vice Mayor, I have a question on this, if I may. I have a concern. The boards and commissions, but I think in this situation, well, boards and commissions report up to the council. And I've never seen in the past, except for with council member when he was council member Alinsky, but I've never seen where a mayor has served on a board or commission. And I know it's your passion, Mayor Alinsky. I know it's your baby, but I just that board reports up to the council, and to have the mayor
serving on a board that reports up to the council, I think there could be a bit of a conflict, maybe not a conflict of interest necessarily, according to Robert's rules, or, you know, but I think there could be some influence, and I don't know, maybe it's time to step aside and let other people handle this particular board. So I'm just throwing it out there. It's a concern of mine. I've never seen it before. I know you served as a council member, but I'll just leave it at that. It's a concern.
And I kind of have to disagree, just because we all serve on different commissions and boards, and we're eventually going to be put in that position. That's why we have the ability to step down and step back. And we try to, you know, control where we can. We try to be as open with our ideas. So I understand, and I know it is a passion of Tim's. And in fact, he's one of the original members of it. So I think he has some great history and some great knowledge to keep it moving. Otherwise, but I do understand where you're coming from.
And currently our guidelines don't address this issue? Obviously not.
I would refer to you. I mean, you've had more experience on council than I. I don't know, or I refer to the city attorney. I don't know if our guidelines address that.
They do not prohibit the dual service, and I think you're right. There is no statutory conflict of interest. The other thing I have thought about in this context before and would think about here, and it's not a problem, is a legal doctrine known as the incompatibility of offices, where an office holder would not be able to simultaneously discharge the duties of both offices. I don't see that as being an issue here either. So it's a legitimate policy discussion and decision for the council, but nothing beyond that.
Okay. So I'm trying to get myself together here. Are we just going to speak to our applicants?
I think since we only had three and we have three openings, there's no interview process. They would just be appointed according to the decisions we made at the meeting when we appointed the commission.
Well, let's go ahead. If they're here and they can address the council with a statement at least.
You want to go ahead and call one up?
Try and find one. Nobody's putting
There's
their hand up.
Alinsky's here, and, oh, yeah. And Jill is here.
I was
here.
Saving him for later.
Jill is here.
Yes, Ms. Clark, would you like to? They found you.
Sorry, I left. I didn't know I could be considered for two, so thank you for considering me for two. Again, you know, everything I said before holds true. I have passion for the community, and I have passion for development and leadership. And history and preservation certainly are a big part of this community and something I would be proud to be part of and learn from Mayor Alinsky and serve the community. So I thank you for your time and your consideration.
Thank you. Mr. Alinsky.
Thank you, Vice Mayor and Council. Appreciate the opportunity. I understand where you're coming from too, Commissioner Althaus, and believe me, I'd love to step down. In fact, I voted against my own appointment as chair last time it came up, and we'll be discussing it shortly if I do get reappointed, and I'll likely vote against my own appointment as chair again, because I agree with you, it is time for others to step forward and serve on these commissions. As you're aware, of course, we've had some challenges in getting folks to apply, and I've been out there beating the bushes to get people to sign up for this one, because this Historic Preservation Commission really does play an integral role in economic development here in Cottonwood. I think we have an untapped resource in our historic resources and our historic inventory here that we really could tap into to push economic development. If you notice, what's happening in Old Town is different than what's happening at the Walmart. And people typically don't come in to a community to visit their Walmart. They want to come into a community to visit the historical area. And many reports have been done and research has been conducted that proves that those areas that are most vibrant in any community, from Seattle to Boston, are those areas which have a very vibrant, historic downtown combined with modern amenities as well. And I think we've got that right here, not just in Old Town, but throughout Cottonwood. And I, you know, my work on the Historic Preservation Commission has been to research the history. We're getting an inventory together of all the historic buildings that we have, and my hope is to really promote that history and start landmarking these properties and really push that history and share it, because we have a great, very rich history here in Cottonwood. So I'd be happy to answer any questions. I'm obviously passionate about it. It's what I do for a living as well, as my day job. And I certainly would appreciate it if the council would appoint me.
Mayor, I was just curious. It says that there has to be at least five of your commission members that live in the city limits.
Mm-hmm.
So are the ones that are on the commission now, are they all living in the city limits? Do you know offhand?
So that's a good question. We have Commissioner Bigelow lives in Clarkdale. Commissioner Palavoda lives in Cottonwood. I believe Commissioner Vernowski lives in Cottonwood as well. I believe the only commissioner we have that doesn't live in the city of Cottonwood is Bigelow.
Okay.
And I believe Mrs. Clark lives in Cottonwood as well.
Okay, because their address is not on their applications.
Okay.
Okay, I just wanted to confirm that we were okay on that.
We have a question.
No, I was saying good. We had great applicants.
Okay. Any other questions and such?
Thank you for the consideration.
Thank you, Mr. Linsky. So apparently we're going to go ahead and approve these tonight.
Yes, sir.
I don't see anything to the contrary here. So do we hear motions?
I'd love to make a motion as soon as I get back to where I need to be. Here we go. If I can make the motion, I move to approve resolution number 2871, appointing Tim Olinsky, a member of the Historic Preservation Commission, for a 3-year term that expires March 22nd, 2020. And do I need to just keep going down the road there?
Sure.
Yes, ma'am. I move to approve resolution number 2872, appointing Felicia Coates, a member of the Historic Preservation Commission, for a 3-year term that expires March 22nd, 2020. And I move to approve resolution 2873, appointing Jill Clark, a member of the Historic Preservation Commission, for a 3-year term that expires March 22nd, 2020.
Second.
So, Ms. Norman seconded that. Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
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 Opposed? City Clerk, would you read resolutions number 2871, 2872, and 2873, inserting the names of Tim Olinsky, Felicia Coates, and Jill Clark, please?
Resolution number 2871, a resolution of the Mayor and City Council of the City of Cottonwood, Arizona, appointing Tim Olinsky, a member of the City's Historic Preservation Commission, and establishing his term of office. Resolution number 2872, a resolution of the Mayor and City Council of the City of Cottonwood, Arizona, appointing Felicia Coates, a member of the City's Historic Preservation Commission, and establishing her term of office. And resolution number 2873, a resolution of the Mayor and City Council of the City of Cottonwood, Arizona, appointing Jill Clark, a member of the City's Historic Preservation Commission, and establishing her term of office. Mr. Vice Mayor.
Thank you, Deputy Clerk. And congratulations, Ms. Clark. You're on a commission now. You're on the way.
Now you've got some work to do.
Okay. Mr. Mayor.
Okay. Thank you very much. Okay, moving on, under new business, item 5 is cooperative use of the Houston-Galveston Area Council of Governments contract number FS12-15 for the procurement of an E1 Cyclone 2 fire pumper apparatus from H&E Equipment Services for the Cottonwood Fire and Medical Department. Chief Kirkendall.
Mayor and Council, Mike Rivendell, Fire Chief. Tonight I'm here to request that the City Council would approve the cooperative use of the Houston-Galveston Area Council of Governments contract FS12-15 for the procurement of an E1 Cyclone 2 fire pumper apparatus from H&E Equipment Services. Just a little background. I know you have heard about the new fire engine as Mr. Rodriguez brought forth last November, seeking approval, and which the council did approve, a lease purchase package, which it includes $600,000 for the purchase of a new fire engine, specifically to replace a 10-year-old now American LaFrance fire apparatus, which, as well as meeting kind of what we see at 10 years is what we look at with the call volume we have, is about the normal lifespan at front line. But also with this apparatus, we've been running into more and more problems because we can't get parts because the American LaFrance company went bankrupt. I've told the story, I think, and many of you here were either on the council or in the audience when we did discuss that. The company that we had bought that from did go bankrupt, and there was no successors to the company, so getting parts has become more and more difficult and almost maybe impossible. So if we didn't replace this apparatus, we did stand the chance of getting to a situation where we wouldn't be able to repair it. That and meeting, it's also just meeting kind of the end of a 10-year lifespan. The timing was good, and we went forth and looked at a number of different apparatus, a number of hours done by Captain Larry Dawson, who's here tonight, spent countless hours going through specifications, looking and comparing between the three manufacturers who have dealerships in the state of Arizona. We've narrowed it down to them initially because of the service work. You want to be able to get your service work done, of course, in the state of Arizona, any warranty work and those things. And after comparing and looking at everything and deciding what was the best value for the dollar, we had looked at decided upon the E1, an E1 apparatus, E1 being the manufacturer in this model, and then started negotiating with the dealer, and then also using the Houston Galveston Association of Governments, which is a procurement contract where they go out to an open bid. So it's an open bid process. And then we're able to, using that pricing and then through additional negotiations, we're able to get them to take an $80,000 discount off of that bid price that was the the price that most would pay to get it into our price range through some negotiating. And again, I think we're getting an excellent deal here. We're in under the $600,000, and they're going to get a lot of truck for the dollar. It seems like a lot of money, but fire trucks are just tremendously expensive and getting more all the time. That's in a nutshell. I'm certainly open to any questions that you would have on this.
Okay. Council, any questions?
I just have a quick statement. I remember the last time that we got a fire truck, and it is an extremely detailed process, a lot harder than going out and deciding which car you want to purchase. There are numerous factors that you have to compare one to another, and it is extremely time-consuming, so I applaud your being able to narrow it down to a specific pumper here, because I know that's tough.
What assurance, Chief, can you give us, if any, that this company won't go belly up and we'll be stuck?
I would love to give you any assurance in that, but what I will tell you is they're the number three largest manufacturer in the country. We looked at all of the three companies we looked at in Arizona are the top three manufacturers in the country. Past experience for us, we did have an E1 that we bought back in 1990, a new E1 apparatus. Since then, we've bought Pearson, Rosenbauer, and American LaFrance. There's not any indication, based on any research that we've done, that there's any likelihood of them going into any financial. They have no record of having any financial things in the past. Also, one of the things that happened in American LaFrance was, in fairness to American LaFrance, they were partly victims of the 2008-2009 decline. Mm-hmm. Nobody was buying fire trucks. We bought ours on the Phoenix contract. It was after we bought that they went bankrupt in that time frame. E1 made it through that time frame, and now actually the fire truck business is good. Cities are buying things because they didn't for a number of years, mm-hmm. didn't have the ability to do that. And in fact, that was when we found that as we negotiated with some of the other manufacturers, They didn't want to cut us any deals at all. Really, part of why we did with E1 is E1 was looking to try to get some trucks in the northern part of the state. They've been selling mostly in the Phoenix metro and southern part of the state. And part of the reason for giving us this discount is they want to have a truck up here so that they can also break into the market. Right now, they're mostly buying, people are buying Rosenbauers and Pearson, the northern part of the state. So we were able to do that. But with that, they do have a dealership in Arizona. We've had good experience in the past with E1, so I have no indication to believe that there's nothing to indicate that they would. I can't guarantee they won't, but American LaFrance was not in the top three in the country even at the time.
Okay.
But we got a good price because we'd packed onto a Phoenix bid.
Right.
And unfortunately, just kind of got caught in that. But we still got 10 years of service out of it. So
okay.
Larry kept together with Band-Aids for 10 years now.
So. All right.
Any other questions? Thank you.
Thank you very much for your presentation. Any here, a council member want to make a motion here? Please.
I move to approve the cooperative use of the Houston-Galveston Area Council of Governments H-GAC contract number FS12-15 for the procurement of an E1 Cycle 2 fire pumper apparatus from H&E Equipment Services, Inc.
Second.
Okay, Councilmember Pfeiffer made the motion. Councilmember Norman seconded it. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? All right, motion is approved. Thank you again, Chief. All right, claims and adjustments.
I move we pay the claims and adjustments.
Second.
Okay. Councilmember Allen made the motion. Althaus seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any opposed? Okay. Pay the claims. And next up is annual review of the city manager. Now, I did send Mr. Bartosz a letter that his review is due, and he indicated he would like to do his review in executive session. So,
motion to move to executive session.
Okay.
Second.
Okay, so Councilmember Althaus made the motion. Allen seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Any opposed? Okay, then we'll move into executive session. We'll come back out after a while. Back. After much discussion, we didn't have a very clear. I move to resolve back in a regular session.
Second.
Mayor made the motion, and Councilmember Norman seconded. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Aye. Okay. We're back in regular session. So anyway, we had a robust conversation and no real clear direction emerged, so I would ask for a motion out here on the floor.
I move we table this item and bring it back at a special meeting or the next regular council meeting to discuss it further with the appropriate documentation requested.
With the what now?
Appropriate documentation.
Okay. You want to elaborate on the documentation?
The last years before strategic initiatives and goals to be addressed by Mr. Bartosz.
I'll second that just for sake of discussion.
So we have a motion from Kyle Allen and a second from Councilmember Pfeiffer. roll call vote, please, Deputy Clerk.
Councilmember Althaus?
No.
Councilmember Norman?
Yes.
Councilmember Pfeiffer?
Yes.
Councilmember Allen?
Yes.
Councilmember Henry?
Yes.
Vice Mayor Harry?
Yes.
Mayor Linsky?
No. So the motion passes. So what we'll do then is bring back the strategic directives from 2014-15, I believe, the last set of strategic directives that the city manager had to work with, and we will use that as a benchmark for evaluating his performance. Okay. And the reason I abstained, or I didn't abstain, excuse me, the reason I voted no, just to clarify, is I feel like council had given pretty clear direction previously that we would move forward with all of our contract employees in the same manner as we've always done, which is without a written evaluation form. So I feel like by doing this, now we're opening up the door for having to meddle with the other contract employees' negotiations and how we move forward with that. I'm not yet clear, but we'll handle it one by one. So thank you, Council. Next item is adjournment.
Second.
So, I'll move that we adjourn.
Okay. Councilmember Henry moved to adjourn. Vice Mayor seconded it. And all in favor?
Aye.
Thank you, Council.